Hi everybody, this is Kefren. Today I'm going to show you how to boost your FPS in Grand Theft Auto 5, whatever version that you have, so the Steam version and the Epic Game 1. So first of all, you want to remove your game mode from your computer, really important, game mode at off. It will first of all improve a little bit your FPS and also you will have less stuttering in the game. Game bar also really important, put this one at off. And capture, put this one at off. So the background recording over there, the recorded audio. Second thing that you really need to do is your graphic driver. Make sure that you have the latest one. So NVIDIA, Intel, AMD. I will put the link in my video description. Make sure that you have the latest driver. It will help you a lot. So now you want to go where you install the game. So depending where is your directory file from Epic Game or Steam. You can right click here, for example, on Steam, go to properties. Local file, rows local key file, and now you will see where you install your game. The one that you really want to do the optimization is the GTA 5 over there, the 75 meg one. Right click on it, click properties, go to compatibility, make sure that disable full screen optimization is checked, and also make sure that override high DPI scaling is checked. Press OK and OK. So now you optimize your execute file. So now let's go inside of the game. So now the perimeter inside of the game. The first thing that you will see is the DirectX version. After my guide, if you're not satisfied with your FPS and you have some, a really old computer like 7 years, 8 years ago, you can definitely test this and go with DirectX 10.1 or even 10. It will help you a lot with your FPS, but you will lose a lot of different effects inside of the game. So definitely you should test it. First of all, screen type, really important, just use full screen. With all the other mode, you will lose 2-3% in your FPS, so really important to use full screen. Resolution independent on your monitor. After my guide again, if you still don't get your 60 FPS, for sure lower your resolution, it will help you a lot. Refresh rate, it depends on the number of hertz of your monitor. If you have a 144 hertz screen, for example, make sure that you putting your refresh rate over there, because by default me was 60 and my both of my monitor are 144, so really important, you don't want to miss that. First of all, anti-aliasing, use FXAA, so this one at on, MSAA, put this one at off. VSync, it really depends if you want to lock sync your monitor with your GPU. Not really important, because honestly I don't see a lot of people who's doing more than 144 FPS, but whatever. If you have like a 60 hertz screen, normally you can lock it and you will lock it at 60 FPS. So now the little slider for population density, variety and distinct scaling. If you use that, honestly you will gain like 12-14% boost in your FPS. So just do some tests if you want a bit more population density, a bit more variety, depending on where you are with your FPS. For example, if you have a 60 hertz screen and you're getting your 60 FPS, you can definitely put this one a little bit higher and do some testing. Texture quality, it really depends on your VRAM on your video card. This game is nice because you see the number of VRAM that you have. So for normally, if you have 4 GB and more, go with very high. If you have 3 GB, go with high. Normal, 2 GB and less. Shader quality, put this one at normal. Shadow quality, put this one at normal also. This one is really, really important, shadow quality. It will give you, if you compare very high to normal, it's like 12% boost in your FPS. So it's pretty huge. Reflection quality, again, go with normal. This one is more like you will stabilize your FPS. Sometimes when a lot of stuff is happening and you have reflection on glass, water, or whatever, you will like see some drop in your FPS. So this pretty much because of this one. Reflection MSAA, I don't know why it's X4. You should definitely remove this. Water quality at normal, particle quality at normal, and grass quality at normal. This one is really important. Another like 7-9% in your FPS. So put those graphic parameter. Soft shadow, put this one at sharp. Post FX, go with normal. And the last is anisotropic filtering, go with X4. This one is really important also. It's a bit like Shadow Ambient Inclusion. Put this one at off. Another like 6% boost in your FPS. And Tessellation off also. If you have an old AMD card, you will see a boost like 8%. And if you have an old NVIDIA card, it's more like 3-4% in your FPS. So if you have any questions, you guys, just comment in the YouTube section. Post me your rig, CPU, GPU, and RAM. I will try to help you the best that I can. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Peace!